Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Leanne, and in today's video, I'm going to talk to you about my June favorites. So I have quite a few favorites this month, a lot of beauty products as compared to last month, and I'm really excited about it. I have some new discoveries, and I am floored with how well a lot of these new discoveries have worked out for me. So let's just get into it. First, I'll start with the makeup products. And I looked at all these products just before I started filming this video, and I realized how many Essence products I have. I don't have like too many, but it just is really new to me. And it's been a really long time since I've actually focused so much on one brand, but Essence is crazy good, like crazy good. Their products are so high quality, and they're all at an affordable price. So I am definitely on the Essence bandwagon. I don't even care that it took me this long to find out about Essence and try them out, but I'm just so happy I have them in my life. So let's just start with the mascaras. I think I mentioned these in my Instagram posts, but I definitely recommend that you check out their mascaras. The first one is the Lash Princess False Lash Effect Mascara. I hauled this in one of my videos back in January or February, and I think I talked about it in one of my favorites videos at that time as well. But this is definitely my favorite mascara from that line, the Lash Princess line. This is the volume mascara, and this mascara is their most recent introduction to my makeup routine, and I definitely love this for an everyday look. Even though it says volume on it, I do not find that it's volumizing at all. Actually, I have it on my lashes today, if you can see it. And yeah, not much volume, but there's a ton of separation and a ton of length. So I love it for that. It's definitely a beautiful mascara to use every day. And it doesn't really hold that much of a curl. Sometimes it does. I don't know. It depends on maybe the humidity of that day, but I don't really know why it didn't really hold my curl today. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't, but it's beautiful for every day. And then the blue one, which is the False Lash Effect one, is volumizing. It's definitely not separating, but it's also lengthening, and it can get a little bit clumpy here and there, but I just really, really love these. The next products are the matte long lasting lip glosses. And I love these so much. I have the shade, they rubbed off on the barcode or label here, so I don't remember. I will link everything down below. The really poopy part about this is that on Ulta's website, they do sell these, but they don't sell these shades. I'm really sad about that, because just in case you're interested in picking them up and you live in the States and they're not available, you can't get them unless you go to Germany, which is where I bought them, or wherever else they have these shades. But this is a beautiful shade of magenta. This is my favorite color of lip product that I love on myself. I have it on my lips right now. I just reapplied it. I didn't wear it today, but I just wanted to wear a little bit of color. I love wearing color on my lips, especially in videos, since I do tend to get very washed out. And this is the perfect color. I love to wear this color. If you know my favorites, I love the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Addis Ababa. That is my favorite lip product of all time. But this is definitely a close second. I would say it's second to that one. They pretty much feel very similar. They dry down very matte, and they're very long lasting, and they are very similar in color as well. So I don't know. I think the NYX ones are more expensive than these, but just because I can't get these here, I might just keep buying the Addis Ababa one by NYX. But I don't know. These last me for a really long time, but I really like this one. And then this one, I remember, is called Cheek Up Your Life. This is the first one that I picked up when I was in Germany. And these, by the way, I picked them all up in Germany. And it's a beautiful hot pink color, and it's perfect for summer. These colors are perfect for summer. This one especially is perfect for spring and summer. And I got so much use out of this one. Just whenever I needed a pop, like a super fruity pop of color, this was my go-to. I did a video while I was still in Germany about the beauty and lifestyle products that I got while I was there in my Airbnb, so I'll link that down below for you to watch. I swatched this in that video, so definitely watch that if you're interested in how this looks. I also did an Instagram post on this product. I didn't do it on this one, so go there and look for the selfie and you'll see what it looks like on my lips. I actually used this in a Get Ready With Me, also in my Airbnb, so I'll link that down below. The next Essence lip product is the Color Boost Vinylicious Liquid Lipstick. I love this lip product as well. It is in the shade Woody Rosy, and this is a beautiful nude color. It actually looks exactly like my lip color. So it is a nude, but I don't know, I was kind of expecting it to be a little darker than my lips, which I think it is, but I think it just gives me just the perfect amount of like even color, not too much color. The thing I love about this is that it's so comfortable on the lips. It glides on, and I know it sounds really weird, but it actually feels very rubbery. I described this in my Instagram post, and you can look at that on my Instagram, but it just feels so rubbery and it's so weird. And it actually stays a little bit wet on your lips. It does dry, but it takes a little bit of time to dry. But when it does, I don't know, it just looks amazing, and my lips just don't feel dry with it on at all. And it lasts, and it doesn't come off until you eat or drink or you just talk for hours like I do. The last Essence product that I got while I was in Germany is the Brighten Up Banana Powder. This has become my favorite under eye setting powder ever. And I was using the Dream Matte Powder by Maybelline for years, and that was pretty much the one and only product, like powder, that I've always used on like all over my face. But ever since I got the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, I actually stopped using that for my under eyes and used the yellow powder here. As you can see, I hit pan on it, but ever since I bought this and I tried it, it knocked this out of the water, like completely out of the water. It smooths my under eyes. It doesn't crease at all. It keeps my concealer on for the whole day. And I'm a very sweaty person. Like even around my eye area, I'm very sweaty there. And it just locks everything in. But the thing I love about it is that it just makes my under eyes look so smooth and I don't know, line free. I have it on today. I've been using it for weeks, like ever since I got it. Well, sort of. And I'm sorry, I'm really tired right now. But I have been loving it. It completely replaced my Kat Von D yellow banana powder. Oh, I think I remember the word. It's silky. It just makes my under eyes look very silky. And it's a very finely milled powder. It's very, very silky, even on your fingertips. I've also been loving the Urban Decay Naked Petite Heat palette. This is such a beautiful palette. I talked about it in my last video, I believe. If my last video is the what I packed in my makeup train case video, then I talked about it in that video. But I know I keep talking about it and that it's like kind of underwhelming. It still is for me a little bit, because I feel like these shadows could have been a lot more pigmented, but they are for, I guess, a more natural like daytime look. I use this for, you know, if I go out in the daytime and I go out, like I stay out until nighttime, I still have this and I use it. So I'm not really like using it for like a daytime look and a nighttime look. It's just whatever shades I have in here, whatever's, you know, fits my mood or matches my outfit, I just go with it and I use it and I love it. I love that it comes with a mirror. I love that there are such wearable shades in here. You wouldn't think that these are that wearable. This is a beautiful terracotta shade, a deeper orangey, burnt orange shade, and an eggplant shade. But I love this shadow palette so much. It just comes in handy for whenever I just want to play around with eyeshadows, and it's been my main eyeshadow palette for the whole trip that I was in Germany. For 2 weeks, this was my go-to palette. Speaking of eyeshadow, I wanted to mention the Maybelline Expert Wear eyeshadow in Acid Rain. And I actually keep this little sticky on it so that it, I don't know, for some reason I get so paranoid about traveling with these products and then they explode in my bag, which I will talk about in just a second. But this is the Shadow, and it's a really beautiful pearlescent glittery blue shade. And the reason I got this is because I needed a single eyeshadow to take with me on travel, because I like to set my eyeliners with a matching shadow, and I didn't have a blue one. And the blue shadows that I do have are in like bigger palettes, and I just don't want to pack bigger palettes when I travel, so I just bought this. I also use this to set my green eyeliner, and it turns my green eyeliner into a really, really beautiful turquoise blue-green eyeliner. It looks so nice. But I've been pairing this with the CoverGirl Liqueline Blast eyeliner, and I don't know what shade this is. I'll link this down below. But this is another favorite of mine this month. This is a beautiful blue eyeliner, but it's not blue like this shadow here. As you can see, it's more like a cobalt blue, and it looks really, really nice. I would imagine this to be beautiful on blue eyes, but I wear colored eyeliner all the time. I don't really wear black. Actually, I don't wear black at all, but I love a little bit of color, and whenever I want a blue look, I do reach for this one. I wanted to mention the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette though. Ever since I stopped using this one, I actually just solely use this palette for this shadow, which I know is really sad, but this was before the refillable palette came out, so I had no other choice but to buy the whole palette. But I have been using this palette just for this shadow right here, and I actually used it. Oh, I didn't use it today. I was actually testing something out, but I use this for contouring my nose and bronzing my face. So I don't really use this for contour, but just for bronzing. And I really, really like it. I stopped using it for a really long time ever since I got the Benefit Hoola bronzer. But I went back to this and I really, really like it. And I love using this with my Sonia Kashuk blending brush. This is an eyeshadow brush. And I don't know if I'll do a video on how I contour my nose now. I could do it. It'll be really quick. But I have been just using this eyeshadow blending brush with this shadow. And all I do is just tap it into the shadow, pinch the brush, and just go down the bridge of my nose and just blend it. And I don't know, it just looks really natural, but it definitely defines my nose and looks really, really good. And I was using the Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation stick in mink, and that looked really, really cakey, and my nose is really dry and it peels all the time, and it just didn't look good. So I stopped using that, and I just experimented and decided, let me just do this technique about like pinching the brush and using this powder, and it works totally fine, and I really like this. The problem with this is that now that I use the banana powder from Essence, and I don't use this one anymore, I don't know if I want to pack this because I'm going away next week. Oh, actually, this will be pre-filmed, so I'll be on my trip. But I don't know if I want to pack this whole thing just for this powder, so I don't really know what I'm going to do. But speaking of like experimentation, because I stopped using that just for today, I wanted to see if the Hoola bronzer would work as my nose contour, because I was doing that for a really long time, but I actually don't really like it. It works just more for bronzing. Obviously, it's a bronzing powder. It's not really a contour shade, so yeah. So since I have been using the Petite Heat palette, what's really been making putting eyeshadows on really fun for me lately is using the Sephora Mini Color Switch by Vera Mona. And I actually hauled this in my Sephora VIB sale, I believe, video last month, 2 months ago, I don't remember. And I finally got to use it, and I love it. It's really, really fun to use. So if you don't know what this is, it's a sponge. You can remove it and rinse it and let it air dry and then put it back in the tin and it'd be like all clean and ready to go. But I really like to use this to use one brush with for my eyeshadow. So this brush and this brush are pretty much the only two eyeshadow brushes that I will pack with me and that I was using during my trip to Germany. And it's been really fun to use with the color switch because I didn't have to pack too many eyeshadow brushes with me. So basically what you do is you get your eyeshadow, and let's just say you want to go in with one shade, you put it in your crease, and then you want to go into another shade or another shadow, but you don't want to dip into the other shade with the same brush, because then you'll get really muddy color. So what you do is you swirl your brush into this color switch. It'll completely remove that shade, and then you can go into the next shade and then apply it, and it will look really, really good. So I have been really, really liking this color switch. I did an Instagram post on it, but I just wanted to really let everybody know that I really love it. These brushes have been my favorite this month as well. This is the MAC 217 blending brush, and this is the MAC 239 flat shader brush. And this has been my brush that I use for my lid shade and my crease color. I actually use this, did I say my lid shade? Yeah, my lid and my crease color. And also to blend out the crease shade with the brow bone shade, and also do a little bit of color on my lower lash line. And this I just use to put brow bone highlight, and then on my inner corners a little bit if I want to. And that's basically all I use for my eyeshadows, just these four products. And lastly for makeup are my highlighters, and I really have been loving my highlighters. I don't know, I didn't really like them this much before when I had my whole collection of highlighters, but I love them now. And the highlighters that I was using for the past 2 weeks are the Gilded Honey highlighter by Laura Geller, favorite highlighter of all time. This is the most beautiful gold highlighter that you'll ever use. And then I have the Jouer Little Holiday set here that I hauled last year. And this is in topaz, rose quartz, and citrine. I will not open citrine up anymore. So I mentioned that something like I get really paranoid about things exploding in my bag. Well, I pack everything in my makeup train case here, and my video will be up before this one, so I'll link that down below for you to watch. But I was doing my makeup in the car on the last day of my trip in Germany, well, second to last day I think, and it exploded in my bag. And that was because I previously dropped this highlighter on the floor. I saw a huge crack in it when I opened it, but I just thought, like, if I just gently tap my brush into it, it won't do anything. So it didn't, but I put it back in my bag after I used it, and then during the same like makeup application I took it out again to use, and that's when I just completely forgot that it was pretty much on the verge of having a mental breakdown. And it had a mental breakdown. It went all over my makeup train case, on my pants, on my bag, and my boyfriend's mom's car seat, so rip. Now let's go on to skincare. I have a few skincare favorites. This first one is the Natural Exfoliating, I think it's bamboo, or maybe it's not bamboo, Natural Exfoliating Mitt that I got from Primark. And I did a Primark haul on my video that is already up, so I'll link that down below for you to watch as well. And I picked this up when I was there for €2, and I love it. I know I just don't want to be that person who uses something a couple times in a month and then tell you that that's my favorite, but I only used this twice and I really, really like it, and I'll tell you why. It's a glove, it's a mitten, so it just fits perfectly on my hand. And it just, I don't know, you look at a mitt like this in store and you just don't think that it'll do much, but it really does. It hugs your skin when you want to exfoliate it. I use this mitt in conjunction with any body scrub that I have that's kind of like more gritty, and it works so well. My skin was kind of peeling and it was really dry last night, but I used this and my skin feels so good today. And I also love this especially for my back knee, and I just use the same like body scrub that I use all over my body, and I use it on my back and my chest, and it's been really, really helping keeping it clear. And I know that it helps also with fading my scars. I mean, I have to do pimple extraction and use an AHA toner on my back to, you know, do everything. But just everything together has been really, really helping my back stay smooth and clear. And I did a post, I just uploaded it today actually, on my blog about the next product that I'll talk about that's been really helping clear up my back knee. But this has been just a favorite body product of mine. It's been a really long time since I found a body product that I really, just really look forward to using. This toner is the Skin Manager AHA Effect Tonic by Alcina, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. I got this when I was in Germany. I got it at their drugstore called DM, and everything that I've been doing for my back has really, really, really been doing well for my back. And this is an AHA toner. It's very fragranced, so I would say if you're very sensitive to fragrance, don't use it. The thing is, it's pretty much only available in Germany as far as I know, but this will last me for a really long time, and it has 190 mils, and it only costs 9.95 euros, which is around $12. So this is very affordable and it's super effective. I did a whole post on it, just read it and you'll know why I love it so much. And I have been using it on my boyfriend's arms as well, and you can just see pictures on my blog about our progress with using that product. The next product is the Pixi Skin Treats Peel and Polish Resurfacing Concentrate. This is just an enzyme peel from Pixi, and I hauled this in my previous video, like I don't know how long ago, maybe last month or 2 months ago, and I've been using it on and off. I kind of just like, if I see it there in my shelf, my skincare shelf, which is right here, I'll pick it up and I don't know, it'll remind me that, hey, I have this. And the reason I don't use it regularly or consistently is just because I have some other scrubs that I want to use up. But I've actually really been liking this. I packed this with me on my trip to Germany because it's really small and it fits in my skincare bag. And what it does is it just feels really gritty, but it's not super abrasive. So I don't feel like my skin is falling apart when I use it. And it really gives my skin this beautiful glow, and it really gets into my pores and kind of cleans everything out. And when I use it in conjunction with the L'Oreal detox mask, and I also got it in Germany last year, yeah, my skin is like pretty much glowing. It's glowing and it's clear, and the day after that my skin is still glowing and it's very clear and very soft and smooth. So these two paired together are, I don't know, they're just amazing to use, and I use them every Wednesday. Well, when I'm away, every Wednesday I actually use some other things, but every Wednesday when I was in Germany, I was using this and I really, really like them. The next two skincare products are by Shiseido, and these are mini sizes that I got from ordering some Shiseido stuff when Macy's had their skincare or beauty sale. This is the Shiseido White Lucent Luminizing Infuser, and this is what you would call an essence. This is actually pretty thick and oily, which is something I'm not used to in an essence. I've been using the Wamisa one for a really long time, and that's pretty, I guess you can say it's oily. It is thick because it's an essence, but this is definitely, it leaves a more oily feel, but I really, really like this. It gives my face a really luminous glow. And I do the three skin method using this toner, this essence, and it keeps my skin very clear and smooth and moisturized. The other product is the Shiseido Ultimune Eye Power Infusing Eye Concentrate, and I've really been liking using this in the morning as my morning eye cream. And the reason I started using this is because the Shiseido Wrinkle Resist one is very thick, so it's perfect for nighttime, and it can get a little bit oily since it's very thick, but this one is more on the watery side and it sinks in really quickly, so I don't have to worry about its interrupting my makeup application. So I've really been liking this, and it keeps my under eyes very smooth and moisturized, especially when I go in with my concealer and powder. Lastly, it's a lifestyle thing, but I've really been enjoying my Ray-Ban sunglasses, and these are the Justin style. I hauled this 2 months ago, I believe, when I went to the eye doctor, and I wanted these so badly when I saw them on the wall. Ray-Ban makes my favorite sunglasses of all time. Ray-Ban was the brand that I started getting into after my little obsession with Coach, and I haven't looked back. These are my favorite glasses, and I got them polarized, and I don't have any glare. It's super dark, so I get really confused about what time of day it is when I'm walking around for a long time. They're that dark. Oh god. That was it for my favorites video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to see more videos from me. Click that notification bell to get notified of all my future uploads. Check out my blog. I, however, will not have any more blogs for the next, I think now, 2 weeks because I am on my trip. And follow me on Instagram to see pictures of my trip. I'm super excited about going there. And I haven't told you where I'm going, but I'm going to Disney World. I will be there by the time you watch this video, and I'm really excited about it. So anyways, I will hope to see you in my next video. Bye.